Well, I think I was an entrepreneur from a very early age because I had to survive. I just adapted to whatever needed to be built. I went from wood frame to concrete construction, and I'd done literally hundreds of modular concrete homes. Post-earthquake in 89, we did a lot of the demolition, cleanup, rescue. Ultimately, we took down that whole partially damaged near collapse freeway in San Francisco along the waterfront down. Everything I thought I knew about structures was changed, seeing how they failed, the partial failure, the near failure, and it gave me a different context. I realized we had to come up with a way, a faster, better way to build, and it had to be safer because safety became a key element.
Bob and I met in 1999, and he had always kind of had this vision of modularizing the way we build, but how do you modularize without forcing the architecture in some way? We've brought it down to the level of how things connect, hence ConXtech. So our connections lower and lock together, and they fit very precisely. It's a very robust, simple, rapid to put together system that allows you to have no braces or shear walls in a structure, to have big wide open space that allows you to put what you want where you want it. We designed the structure to build in California, which has some of the toughest seismic code in the world.
In the very beginning, we tried to take advantage of the platforms that Autodesk was creating. We use the Inventor platform for all of our connector pieces that are highly machined, the machine code that goes out to the shop floor to machine the parts.
We have standard connections, standard parts that we've integrated into Revit. And very early on in the design process, we can get a drawing, even a napkin sketch, and get a few pieces of data, and we can very quickly populate a Revit model with our parts and pieces. We can turn that model around to the architecture or the design team and show them how we would frame a building with our system. People say, well, how do I know it's going to fit? What if I get a piece in the field that doesn't fit? So we've developed a set of what we call mating surface simulating fixturing. As a column or beam goes through our factory, it fits into a fixture that is basically what it will connect to in the field. So rather than thinking from the field back, you're thinking from a more manufacturing perspective. We can build almost anything. We're trying to give that architect big wide open space that they can do what they want to do.
The characteristics of the ConXtech system, where it's gravity stabilized, lowered and locked, puts a lot of the risk profile that's associated with conventional steel, it takes it out of the equation. We didn't just add rules to the work, we changed the work. We made the work safer.